Hi everyone, welcome to the Data Analysis Skill Series with Jamovi. In this session, we will learn Descriptive Statistics. Descriptive Statistics is a branch of statistics where we summarize, organize and simplify our data so that a meaningful information can be obtained out of the data. In Descriptive Statistics, we draw a sample from that population. But we don't try to infer about the population, and whatever estimate we are taking out, we try to describe our sample. We never do hypothesis testing in descriptive statistics. Whereas in inferential statistics, we describe about the sample, but we always try to infer about the population from where we have drawn the sample, and we do the hypothesis testing also, like we make a null hypothesis, we make an alternate hypothesis, and then either we reject the null hypothesis or we accept the null hypothesis. So this is the difference between a descriptive statistics and a inferential statistics. So in descriptive statistics, first we try to make a frequency distribution. So frequency distribution is applicable for categorical variable. Like in this example, you can see the BMI has been made into the category normal, overweight and obese, and then frequency and percentage of that is depicted here. So this is the frequency distribution. The second is the central tendency. So the second measure of descriptive statistics is the central tendency, and in this we take mean, median and mode. The third is the measurement of variability. So a data can have a low variability, a medium variability and a high variability. And in subsequent part, we will see about each three in detail. So frequency distribution, like I said, it is for the categorical variable. So we make a group frequency table. We make a class interval of a continuous data. That class interval should be based on some predefined criteria, or generally all intervals should be of same width. We make frequency distribution graphs also, and in case of a continuous data we make histogram, whereas in case of a categorical data we either make bar graph or pie chart depending on the need of the data. Then third is the percentile. So if we describe our data into four parts, that is the quartile. If we describe our data into the five parts, each part is known as quintile. And if we make a 10 part of our data, then each part we call it as a decile. So that is the frequency distribution. As a measurement of central tendency, if the data is normally distributed, generally we calculate mean. If the data is skewed, we calculate median, because median is not affected by the extreme values, whereas the mean gets affected by the extreme values. So if the data is skewed, we calculate the median. And then one data which is of greatest frequency in a series of observation, we call it as a mode. The measurement of spread is measured as a range, where the range is described as the highest minus lowest, or standard deviation and variance of a population, and standard deviation and variance of a sample. So these are the three measures for measuring the spread of the data. So let's learn the statistics on Jamovi. So in Jamovi, the exercise which has been given to me, that is I have to calculate the appropriate summary statistics for age, gender, race, socioeconomic status, cardiovascular disease status, MI order, where MI is the myocardial infarction, type of MI, where it is the first attack or recurrent attack, height, weight, body mass index and BMI category. So these are the summary statistics for which I have to calculate the descriptive statistics. So let's see how to do the statistical analysis on Jamovi. So you know how to install Jamovi and how to import a data. But importation of data, I'll show you here also. So this is the menu bar. Click on import. Then click on browse. This will lead to a folder, so you can give the pathway. So data is saved here. So any type of data can be imported. Like this is a SPSS file, but you can import a Excel data, SPSS data, and then click this open, and then this prompt comes that file imported and the file importation was successful. You will observe that first three columns, these are the data set or the variable which has been created already. So we don't need this, so you can delete these three. So press Control, press all these three, right click, and then you can delete these variable, press OK. So now you can see your ID number, age, gender, race, socioeconomic status. These are the small form of the variables which has been created already. This is CVD, is the presence of cardiovascular disease. This MI order is the first order MI or the recurrent MI. Type of myocardial infarction is the Q wave and non-Q wave. Similarly, the weight, height, these are the continuous data, and the BMI. So this is there. Then again, there is a BMI category. So this is the data. Now the statistical descriptive statistics which I have to perform is of age, gender, race, socioeconomic status, cardiovascular disease, MI order, type, height, BMI and BMI category. So there are two types of variable with me. There is a continuous variable and there is a categorical variable. So for a continuous variable, I'll show you first with the continuous variable. So in the above this strip, you can see there are four options. This is variable. So these are the name of the variable you can see. Then this is the data. This is the data set. And if you press this analysis, then these are the various tests options which we have. So right now I have to perform descriptive statistics. So this option of exploration gives me the option of descriptive statistics. So I'll click this. I press this descriptive. If you click this, it will lead to a window. There is a variable view. And in the down these two strips, you can see the statistics and plot. So first I'll show you with the continuous nature of the data. So here the continuous data is the age, maybe the weight, height, although we don't calculate weight and height separately, we generally take BMI. But again, just to show you, this is the BMI. So these are the variables. So by default, you will see that the mean, median, standard deviation and range, that is the minimum and maximum of all these four continuous variable you can see here, because that is already by default it is clicked, that mean, median and the standard deviation, and then dispersion, that is the mean and median. If you want to test for the normality of data, then you can click this Shapiro-Wilk, because Shapiro-Wilk tells us about whether the data is normally distributed or not. So if you click this, again it is a dynamic, the beauty of this Jamovi is that the output is dynamic. If you click this, it will appear. If you uncheck this, it disappears. So you can see about the data, you can see the value of this Shapiro-Wilk, and here you can see that the value of Shapiro-Wilk, it is less than 0.001. that means it tells you about that the data is whether it is a normally distributed data or not a normally distributed data. So right now I am not focusing on this. So this you can see here, and then again if you want that standard error of mean and 95% confidence interval of the mean, you can check that. So this you know about the descriptive. Now what you have to do, that you save this, you copy this table and then save it to another Word document. Go open a Word document, go and save this, because the problem with this Jamovi is it's since it is dynamic in nature, so you don't have a saved output in your folder. So every time you have to copy paste this in a Word, the output which you want to paste it in the result. So this was about the continuous data. Now the second about the categorical one. So for categorical one, I need the frequency tables. But for frequency table, I need to uncheck this, because if you don't uncheck this for a categorical data also, because it is a software. So for categorical data also, it will give you a mean and median. So I have unchecked this because I don't want mean and median of my categorical data. And I will move this to back to this view. And then again, I want categorical. So categorical data in my case is the gender, race. So press Control button, select all these type of categorical data, and then there is a BMI category also. You select this BMI category, move this to this box, and then click on this frequency table. So if you click on this frequency table, you can see that this male and female counts and percentages, it will be displayed. Similarly, the race, the socioeconomic status, the frequency and percentage, the CVD, MI order. So all that categorical variable you can see, it will give you the percentages and the numbers. If you want to plot the graph, so if you click on this option of plot, you can see you have got various plot here. So like what plot, if you want to take out from any data, you can check a particular plot and then it will come to your output. And again, keep copying and pasting this to a separate Word document, because once you import another data or you uncheck this, then this output will be lost. So keep doing that work so that you have a backup with yourself that is ready for interpretation. And then this particular table, you can write the interpretation about a descriptive statistics. So that's how we perform a descriptive statistics in Jamovi. Thank you.